Hello students, today we will study about dihydrogen. See, dihydrogen, it is a diatomic molecule having two atoms, H2, its atomicity is 2. First, we will study about the isotopes of hydrogen. There are three isotopes of hydrogen, protium, deuterium and tritium. All of them, they have atomic number 1, but their masses are different due to difference in their number of neutrons. See, this is protium. It is the ordinary hydrogen having atomic number 1 and mass also 1. Naturally occurring hydrogen, it contains 99.985% of the isotope. Means major is this isotope only. Now deuterium, it is also called heavy hydrogen. It can also be denoted by capital D. It is found 0.016% in naturally occurring hydrogen. Now tritium, it is radioactive in nature and it is extremely rare isotope. Now we will study about the preparation of dihydrogen. First we will study about the general methods. From water, if first we will see by the action of metals. Here we have taken very active metals. Very active metal, when they are added to water, they liberate dihydrogen. Like we know that sodium and potassium, they are very active metals, very reactive metals. And when these reactive metals, they are put in water, they vigorously react with water to form hydrogen gas along with the formation of an alkali. Now second one, they are the less active metals like magnesium, aluminium. They are less active metal and they cannot react with cold water. They react with water upon heating. When they are heated with water, they react to form oxides and hydrogen gas. See here, these very reactive metals, they are reacting with water to form hydroxides. And these less active metals, they are reacting with water upon heating to form oxides only, along with the formation of hydrogen gas. Now the third category of metal, these metals, they react with steam. Means their reactivity is very less with water. They react with steam at high temperature. Like iron is there. Iron, when it reacts with steam at high temperature, it forms Fe3O4 along with the formation of hydrogen gas. And this process is called Lane's process. Here, iron, it is reacting with steam. Neither with hot water nor with cold water, but it is reacting with steam at high temperature to form Fe3O4 and hydrogen gas. Now second one, by the action of hydrides. This was about the action of metals. Now action of hydrides with water. Like sodium hydride, it is alkali metal halide. This is calcium hydride, alkaline earth metal halide. Means alkali metal halides and alkaline earth metal halides, when they react with water, they form bases or alkalis along with the formation of hydrogen gas. Like NaH, it reacts with water to form sodium hydroxide and hydrogen. This is calcium hydroxide, it reacts with water to form calcium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. So the first one here, if you'll see, from water, it is all we are starting it with water only. The first one is by the action of metals. In metals, here we have studied about very active metal, less active metal, and the metals which are lesser than these less active metals, lesser active. Now by the action of hydride, here it is reacting with water to form an alkali and hydrogen gas. Now third one is electrolysis process. Dihydrogen of a very high purity can be prepared by the electrolysis of water, and here the water which we take, it is acidulated or a base is added to it. These acid or base, they enhance the conductivity of water. See here, actually electricity is required, which is not possible in every area, so this is a costlier process. But the hydrogen which is obtained here, it is of high purity. Water, it undergoes hydrolysis and we obtain hydrogen and oxygen gases. Now fourth one is the by the action of steam on hydrocarbons in coke. When steam, it reacts with coke at 1270 Kelvin temperature, we get water gas. It is a combination of CO plus H2. Water gas is obtained, and this process is called Bosch process. So whatever we have studied here, it was the preparation of hydrogen from water. Now we will see the preparation of hydrogen from acids. We know that all the acids which are present above hydrogen in the electrochemical series, they can displace hydrogen from acids. Yes, like zinc, if we'll put this zinc in any dilute solution of mineral acid, it can easily displace this zinc from acid, and we will obtain zinc sulfate and hydrogen gas. So it is from acid, like from water, so many reactions are there, and this was from acids. Now from alkalis we will study, like zinc. We know that certain metal oxides, they are amphoteric in nature, means they can react with acid as well as with base to form salt and water. Here if you'll see this zinc, aluminium and SN, they are reacting with sodium hydroxide to form, see, zinc will form Na2ZnO2, that is sodium zincate and hydrogen gas. Aluminium, when it will react with sodium hydroxide and water, it will form sodium aluminate and hydrogen gas. And when SN will react with sodium hydroxide and water, it will form Na2SnO3, that is sodium stannate, double NaT is stannate and hydrogen gas. So this all was the preparation of hydrogen, and this was the general method. Okay, now tomorrow we will study about the laboratory preparation of hydrogen gas. Thank you.